our products and you know, all the Rouse's stores.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Are you talking about the season?
I'm talking about the seasonings, the sauces.
I have the original version of I'm a whole.
Yeah.
I have the original version of the song, and I just went to going off, and Jelly, she just grabbed the microphone, and she immediately, she was feeling me. She was like, ooh, like watching me, like already feeling like where I'm going.
This moment can't replace it, sitting around so lazy.
I'm from the city of New Orleans, you know where to find me. Uptown to be exact, I got my fan behind me.
Boom, clack, bass heavy in the back. Kodaks and throwbacks, pink smoke and cognac are trippy. Boo-boo 50 in my Timmy's pretty.
Oh, na, na, na.
Really?
Oh, na, na.
Welcome to Fat, Fat, and All That. This the new wide episode. I'm here. I'm your boy, Tony the Banker. I'm with Weed At. Man, look.
Blessings.
Peace and love with it.
You already know that.
You know, before we heard the phrase Weed At, before you, Weed At, we thought of the football games, Florida leagues, and things of that nature. But you've taken Weed At and turned it into a restaurant. Yes. You know, when people think Weed At now, they want to go get the chicken.
Sure.
They want to go get the fries. They want to go get the punch. They want to come see you take a picture by the mirror. Where did you start at with it all? You know, I know, but I want you to tell a story that the people know. Where did you start it all from?
Right. So, you know, born and raised in the 7th Ward, Endicott High School.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Tuskegee University, they got to put that in there. You know what I'm saying? But from Tuskegee, wound up landing a job in corporate America. Corporate America wasn't for me. They wound up doing a company-wide layoff. I worked for Frito-Lay. So
yeah.
Frito-Lay was one of the biggest salty snack
companies. Very huge. Very huge.
You know what I'm saying? But at the time, they was doing a company-wide layoff.
Uh-huh.
And they didn't lay me off, but I seen people around me that had been there for 20 plus years.
Why stay and wait for the storm to hit?
So that's when I wound up, I never forget, I was living in Selma, Alabama at the time.
Wow.
So I was watching like the whole food truck race, the whole food truck phenom that was on TV and stuff like that. I was like, man, I'm like, that's something I could do.
But you gotta be pumping in that food truck industry. Your food gotta be good or phew.
Right.
Yeah.
So wind up taking everything that I had, like worked 6-7 years with Frito and wind up pointed into a food truck that I knew nothing about.
That's dope.
So
that's dope.
From the food truck, like I said, I wound up transferring down to New Orleans because I had been in Alabama for 8-9 years from, you know, college and then working. I'm like, man, it's time for me to come home anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
So wound up getting back to New Orleans with the food truck, still with Frito-Lay, and I wound up, you know, going full force with that.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? Just, I mean, the rest is history. I knew nothing about being on a food truck.
Yeah.
Didn't go to culinary school. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Cooking in a restaurant, knew nothing about.
That's how it always happened. That's how it always happened.
Nothing about it, bro.
Yeah.
And I just remember, like, just being on that food truck. I mean, I'm talking about, like, on the way back from buying a food truck in Athens, Alabama, driving that thing back to New Orleans. Catching flat tires, you know what I'm saying? I mean, getting the truck down to New Orleans.
It ain't easy, y'all. If y'all trying to get a food truck, listen to the man. It ain't, you don't just get it and you blow up, you know?
Dealing with issues with other restaurants, you know what I'm saying, giving me a hard time because the truck parked in the same vicinity, so.
So you competition.
Well, that's what they, I mean, at the time, that's how they was looking at it.
Yeah.
And it's like, you know, I mean, if they go in a restaurant, they go in a restaurant.
Right.
If they come in a food truck, they come in a food truck.
So I was asking you about the Snoop situation, and you were telling me kind of like you fed Snoop, or give me the rundown.
So I had the food truck in L.A. My boy Dan Root came to the food truck, told me that Uncle Snoop wanted something to eat, got him the lemon pepper, but I kept the seasonings on the truck too. So I put the seasonings in the truck. I mean, I put the seasonings in the bag, tied it up. They got the food. I got a video that night from Dan, from Oak, you know what I'm saying, doing that.
Oh, like, come on, Snoop, that's what's up.
Feel the rush from a simple touch, maybe roll some rush.
I love it.
I got another video that I posted, you know what I'm saying, when he said, who that?
Yeah.
We that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I think that might have been the one
saying?
I saw.
That's so, you know what I'm saying, always, you know what I'm saying, he always showed me love. I went full force with the products. So we got our products and, you know, all the Rouse's stores.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Are you talking about the season?
I'm talking about the seasonings, the sauces.
Wow.
Like I said, I got a red beans. Of red beans like that, equivalent to Blue Runners and Camilla.
Wow, a weed ass.
A weed ass.
Man, so, that's dope.
Man, bro, it's, when I tell you, man, it's on. I'm locked in, bro.
Yeah.
Just give me the ball.
Yeah.
Blue Runners for about 3 months now. It's inside of Walmart.
Wow.
So we did the whole McDonald's effect.
He said Walmart, y'all. That's deep. If you're in Walmart, that's the next step to like a serious chain. Yeah. You know, in Walmart, all you see is McDonald's and Subway. So
McDonald's, Subway's, and Burger King.
And Burger King.
So being able to break down that barrier, being a black-owned restaurant inside of this super retailer, man, is just absolutely amazing, man.
Was a late Sunday when the drama went down. Ghetto twins on the spins, hustler foot of the crown. On the lake deck swinging, so you know we drinking. Roll the L's up on the trunk of the truck, so you know we drinking. Boom, clack, bass heavy in the back. Kodaks and throwbacks, pink smoke and cognac. I'm trippy. Louis Vuitton in my suit is pretty. I got my girls with me. Debbie, Brittany, and Brittany, friend, and Kitty. We all chilling on that red legs, leather pants, dookie black, short shorts, bitch, I take your man. Snowballs and alcohol sweating out my drawers. I'm about to hit the wall. I leave it sleazy breezy west coast, so then please believe me. Sonically, I mix a hippie like bombing up the levees. Sipping on this bitch, swaying, swipping on the switch. My song, come on, they need this own DJ. Put the bitch.
Fat and All That's brought to you in part by Domino's Pizza, McDonald's, T-Mobile. We'll be right back.
At Domino's, we're constantly innovating to find better ways to deliver you pizza, which is why we're testing driverless delivery powered by Nuro. And it's got someone back to their old habits. Avoid the noid when you get any two or more medium two-topping Domino's pizzas delivered for just $5.99 each.
I'll give you 2.5 of my 10-piece chicken McNuggets for a quarter of your quarter pounder with cheese.
But judging by weight, mine's worth at least 4 chicken McNuggets.
From a cost standpoint, they're of equal value.
But I'm older, so.
Get two of your faves, like 10-piece McNuggets or a quarter pounder for just $6. Only at McDonald's.
I'm really nervous. I don't know what I should wear.
Just wear something not too crazy. Remember, it's a business dinner, not a costume party.
On the Spotty Network, this is what she heard.
Just wear something crazy. Remember, it's a costume party.
Costume party.
Yes.
Don't trust first impressions to just any network. Go with T-Mobile, the crown jewel of 5G.
Anybody want to split a turkey leg?
Welcome back to Fat, Fat, and All That. It's your boy, Tony, you heard me? Man, I'm a hoe. I'm here with your boy, Hot Sizzle, the voice, you dig? Man, hot, top of the charts. I was out of town when I heard him first. I ain't even hear him first in NOLA. I heard him first in H-Town, baby. Listen, how does it feel to be that man just at the top of the charts? You know, I know everything is changing. How you feeling right now?
Good.
How that voice feeling, man?
Amazing. Everything good.
You know, I've been listening so much. You know, when somebody hot, you know, I've been seeing you. But you know, when they hot, you go to looking back on old stuff they did. And I'm like, I like that dot diggy thing you do. Man, how you do that thing, bro?
Believe it or not, my mom told me when I was born
that
they had to cut my tongue because my tongue, I couldn't get my tongue out my mouth.
We would have never known that. You know what I'm saying? Listen, you would never know the story unless you really ask, man. How the single doing, man?
It's doing amazing. It was number one in Louisiana. Thank God for that.
God is good.
And it's been doing amazing in the southern region, and it hit the north region, and it's been doing good in Jersey,
okay,
Maryland, Delaware. Shout out to everybody in the north, New York.
Definitely.
It's doing amazing.
Oh, it is, because I just flew in from Maryland this morning, and it was playing it. They loved it. They out there on the boardwalk listening to it. What about this video, man? I was looking at this video. Man, that video is dope. I don't even know how to explain it. Give me the concept. Is it your mind producing this, or?
Yes, I'm executive producer of the video. Yeah. Me, my friend Cameron, and Vince, who's the directors, and my best friend Joe Jackson. Okay. Joe, we came up with these ideas. We sat down in the front room and just went to talking about multiple things of our ancestors and everything about pretty much like where we come from. And the look just give you, if you can see, like, that's what we come from. That's our great great grandparents.
My people excited, we looking at the future. We ain't nearsighted, underdog central. You need to recite it, and if you can't, then call it mad, cause we gon' have a problem. I'm from the city of New Orleans, you know where to find me. Uptown to be exact, I got my fam behind me. Outsiders hang around, cause my future is shiny. But if you ever fall off, that's when they all haul off. So I'm working hard, and I tread lightly, cause these my favorite Nikes, and they was kinda pricey. That's why these people like me, ayy. I'm always in go mode, got that S on my chest, like the sky logo. Pull up, pull up, ayy, pull up, pull up, ayy, pull up, pull up, ayy, pull up, ayy, pull up, ayy, pull up, ayy, pull up.
So how did the song come about? How did Jelly get into it?
Me and actually the whole pandemic thing, I still had the live stream at the Dragon's Den. Dope. And the only residence I have in the city is at the Dragon's Den. Okay. On Thursday night. And that one Thursday night, me, Jelly, a few other friends, we all went there with my DJ Rocky.
Okay.
And I just went to, I have the original version of I'm a whole.
Yeah.
I have the original version of the song, and right. I just went to going off, and Jelly, she just grabbed the microphone, and she immediately, she was feeling me. She was like, ooh, like watching me, like already feeling like where I'm going.
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, she was just like, I'm just about to start ad-libbing off of everything, you know, he's saying. So she just went to singing on the background.
That's dope.
And as she's singing on the background, whatever, I'm just going off about being a hoe.
Yeah.
And she just went to saying, no. Yeah. Like, you know, you're not, you my friend, you're not no hoe. And I was just like, you know, we hoes. She was like, no, I'm not a hoe. You don't know, nobody knows.
Right.
So we really, like, jost off it. And the next thing you know, we did it again.
Josting, for y'all that's not from the NOLA or down south, that means chilling, hanging out, you know, keeping a peace with each other.
Right, vibing.
Yeah, vibing.
So we did it again the second time. The second time I did it, my girlfriend now, which is my baby mother right now.
Congratulations, brother.
Thank you.
Yeah.
She was there, and that's Jelly best friend.
Wow, dope.
And she was there. And
I
went to rapping a song again, but Josin once again, vibing with her, messing with her, looking her in the eye, saying, I'm a hoe, you know, playing with her, laughing at Josin, and Jelly was no. And that's the version that everybody has now.
Right, and it's dope.
That's where.
That's that gumbo, man, when you just mix it together right like that.
And it's like the first time we did it, it was just, you know, freestyle playing. The second time we did it, it was still freestyle playing, but we knew exactly.
Put a little structure to it.
Right, we put a little structure to it. We knew exactly what was going for to get yourself. I have watched over the years of kings being recreated in a bounce game, from DJ from T.T. Tucker to DJ Jubilee to Josephine Johnny to Willie Puckett to Fifth Wall Weeby to Chopper to all these different artists. Mm-hmm. To me right now.
Yeah. And then I'm saying to the next one, you can't do what I do.
Right.
Don't copy. It's not a copy.
And it's not. It's
an advancement.
From Hot Boy Round on down, everyone had their style, their sound, from Partners in Crime.
Correct.
We all kings.
They got a 15-year-old right now getting ready for when you get old.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And, you know,
man.
Right now, he getting ready, you dig? Right. So, do you classify yourself rapper, singer? What would you call it?
Believe it or not, I don't qualify myself as none of those. I'm an entertainer.
Ooh.
Get you some. Everybody get you some. Get you some. Everybody get you some. Get you some.